Warm welcome to everyone to this event. I'm really glad. I think this is one of my first non-media and entertainment event which I'll be presenting our solutions to the audience, and I'm really very glad. Thanks to Animation Express also for letting Autodesk do such a presentation to this lovely audience from the design and visualization industry. So let me just quickly share my screen, introduce myself. I've already been introduced, but I come from a media and entertainment background. My name is Samit Shetty, and I'm the technical specialist with Autodesk. We all know Autodesk. We are pioneers in the design manufacturing industry, and of course, the media and entertainment industry, where we have softwares for the blockbuster, for animation and visual effects tools. For blockbuster movies and TV episodics and OTT platform. At the same time, we are pioneers in the design manufacturing space as well. So what I'm going to talk about today is visualization in the design industry and using the most advanced tools from Autodesk. Why is visualization very important? Is because visualization helps us bid wins, win bids, because we generally tend to design using CAD softwares, but they still look 2D, they still look like in a design phase until the time when we have completed the actual infrastructure and it's ready to view it live. But there is a space in between from the design till the manufacturing space where we are not really convinced and we would like to see how the end result would be. And that's where the need of photorealistic rendering, AR, VR technologies currently has come into picture, which has made these kind of need possible so that before the thing is actually done or actually is ready to see in real life, we have these technologies which makes it possible to visualize it in right in front of us. Now, the visualization is everywhere, and we can start with to talk or discuss from the interior visualization part, where we have some real success stories from IKEA. We all know IKEA is one of the biggest brands of visualization and furnitures and so on. And from 2006 onwards, IKEA started to develop 3D CGI imageries from a simple pine wood chair. And now if you see, they have over 75% of their products, imageries being developed in using 3ds Max. So 3ds Max is one of Autodesk products, which is widely used in the media and entertainment industry, and not just M&E, but also a lot of architects and design whiz people use 3ds Max to bring the design into a live photorealistic imagery world. So coming back to IKEA, approximately 35% of their fully interior shots are created using 3ds Max completely. And this is still an old data, and more than 25,000 photorealistic imageries they produce in a year. I'm sure it has increased in the last one and a half years for sure. The entire catalog is traditionally a combination of CGI images as well as photography. And the CGI imagery trend is increasing more. And the reason behind that is the team of IKEA themselves have said that it's very easy for them to customize their furnitures, anything, like be it, for example, a kitchen set where you have already designed it, but you just want to do some minute changes based on countries or regions or people. So if the kitchen set in US would be different than kitchen set in Japan or Germany or maybe India. So all they need to do is just do some minute tweaking, and the entire design is ready region based. So that's one of the most appealing feature is what they feel about 3ds Max. And they've clearly said that without 3ds Max, this wouldn't have been possible. Now let's talk about another success story, which is, we'll talk about exterior visualization, right? So we have another customer called as Delta Tracing. They are into exterior visualization, where they produce wooden houses. It was founded in 1999. Very well known in the Europe for rendering brand, and they use 3ds Max exclusively to create these photorealistic images. And that's one of the most used tool in their company to produce photorealistic imageries. Now, how do they do that and all is what I'm going to talk about. Now, as I said, 3ds Max is one of the most powerful tools used in the design viz environment. And along with Arnold, a combination of Arnold and 3ds Max makes it super powerful. What is Arnold? I'm going to talk about in the next few slides. But 3ds Max, as I already said, it's one of the best in visualization because of its flawless workflow. It produces photorealistic imageries, which is what our requirement is now, plus the one-click workflow to any VR solutions. And it also has a seamless workflow with other CAD solutions or our CAD solutions like AutoCAD, Revit, Inventor, SketchUp, and much more. It, as I said, it has a very seamless interop between SketchUp and Autodesk products. There's a live link between Revit. You can easily export and import data between AutoCAD, SketchUp, and Revit and use 3ds Max. 3ds Max has one of the best modeling tools where you can create any kind of complex models, be it furnitures, be it buildings, be it flooring, or be it lampshades, any kind of designs. You can very easily create it and render it out as a photorealistic imageries. It's very powerful tool, which is populate and fluid simulations, helps you create crowd in case if you have a mall or if you have a park which you have created and you want some kind of people walking around to make it much more realistic, the populate tool makes it much more easier. At the same time, you want to have some fountains, you want to have some rains or any kind of liquid simulation, the fluid systems of 3ds Max makes it much more appealing and powerful. And it also has one step VR workflow, so be it Unreal, be it Unity, be it its own Autodesk own VR solution that is Max Interactive, which comes free with 3ds Max. If you want to have a VR experience, absolutely seamless. Now, let's look into the photorealism part of what I was talking about. Now, we have come a long way when it comes to the development of a 3ds Max. We know that 3ds Max is not a very new product. It's been there for years, and we've kept on developing the tools more and more to make it more and more powerful so that the artists do not spend a lot of time doing fine tuning, look development, because lighting, doing a realistic lighting also needs a lot of time and patience. Rendering, we all know that is a very time consuming job. So this image on your screen, what you can see is not a rendered image, but this is a viewport output. So you'll be really surprised to see such kind of an output on the viewport itself, which looks like a final rendered output. So that's possible because 3ds Max from last two versions supports physical materials. And we all know what physical materials are. It's PBR shaders and so on, which does not need to be rendered because they are capable of showing the final output kind of almost 90 to 95% of final output without rendering on the viewport itself. And that's one of the beauty of 3ds Max viewport, physical materials, and PBR shaders. A combination of all this makes it possible on the viewport itself. So imagine the kind of time the artist will save doing a look dev without adding lights and without hitting the render button, but seeing everything on the viewport itself. So how is that done? Let me just take you to a tour of how this actually works. Inside 3ds Max, before we do any kind of a lighting, 3ds Max environment now supports HDRI mapping, which is high definition dynamic range imageries. You can apply that as a background environment and you can change the orientation. You can change the exposure or the height, whatever you want to. That exposure will actually affect the light. You can also make the background blur so that it behaves like a camera depth of field. And you can also make the background image as a ground projection so your objects looks as if it's sitting on a surface without even actually creating a plane. Now you can go online and download any kind of PBR shaders. There are tons which are available free of cost. You can add those shaders into 3ds Max library, or you can directly drag and drop them from your desktop or any file saving area. And you have support for PBR materials, and PBR materials, if you know, has different passes. So you can apply those PBR shaders to its relevant passes, be it metalness, be it roughness, be it ambient occlusion, or the normal diffuse map. Once you do that and apply it to any object, floor here in this case, you can see without rendering, you are actually seeing a photo realistic rendering kind of a wooden floor. Now this is very simple. We haven't even worked upon it. Same way you can do it for the sofa, for the couch as well. If you want to have a leathery, jazzy looking sofa set, you just need to have a leather shader, and all you need to do is apply this leather shader to the couch, and you have a very, very good looking photorealistic final output for the leather output. And same thing, if you want to mix and match 2-3 shaders and apply it like to the furniture, be it the table, be it the coffee mug, and make it a little matte finish, because you don't want the coffee table to be very shiny. So you can add another wooden texture, combine it with a normal PBR shaders, and then change the material orientation to a very shiny finish or a rough finish, a matte finish output or something like that. And you can change the output to a very quick method. Now, similarly, I'm just going to take a few steps ahead. And once you have done the same for the carpet, for the background, for the couch and everything, all you need to do is just click on the viewport high quality render and viewport high quality output. And this is what you're going to see without even hitting the render button. So all my designers who are watching this show are very well aware of the pain which we go through hitting the render button and waiting for the renders to happen. And then when you realize that this lighting is not working, you go back, you change the lighting orientation, and again hit the render button. A lighting artist spends a lot of time in this, and the viewport output and the PBR shaders both together does this job very easy. All you can do is hit the render button when you're ready to output. Now, when you want to hit the render button, as I said, a combination of 3ds Max and Arnold makes it possible. So what is Arnold? For all 3ds Max guys who have not known this lately, we have this new render engine called as Arnold put inside 3ds Max and Maya free of cost. So there is no need of purchasing a separate render engine. Earlier we had Mental Ray, which we discontinued, and we acquired this tool, which was a very popular tool. Arnold has won awards, Academy Awards, and it is very easy and user-friendly to use. Hence, we put it inside 3ds Max and Maya for free of cost. And relatively, as compared to the other tools, Arnold is super free. And it is very capable of handling huge, massive, complex scenes. And that's why it became very popular in the VFX industry, and now slowly getting into the design based industries as well. Arnold supports physical materials. It can render large scale scenes from Revit database. It supports SkyDome and Sun Positioner. It also works with the photometric light, and it has very strong support for VR as well. Now, if you see quickly Arnold visualization, you import files from your Revit or any other CAD softwares. For example, 3D file is already ready. All you need to do is position your lights in such a way and quickly hit the render button, and you can achieve rendered images like this, what we can see. And here we are just changing the outside environmental map so that the light which falls on this inside area is from the exterior output. So you can see how quickly can we produce some photorealistic output. We can also use the denoiser in case if your images have noise. Denoisers in Arnold is super fast and easier. Arnold, as I said, is extremely capable of handling large scenes. So if your scene has thousands and thousands of foliages or trees or jungle, like for example, in this, you have 10,000 trees loaded in this Arnold. And you can see we are just moving the viewport, and Arnold renders it quickly. So even if your scenes are heavier, massiver, and extensive with all these kind of polygons, Anil can handle these scenes very easily. After the acquisition of Anil, we did work on this tool a lot to make it much more stronger and robust. And hence, we have a strong support for Anil GPU from two versions, from 2019 financial year, like 2019 December onwards, we introduced the Anil GPU tool, which is completely supported. And people have shared this wonderful images rendered from the Anil GPU. So I'm just going to take a step back and start from where I had left. We showed you the viewport output, but what we are seeing right now is the actual rendered output from the Anil render engine. You can see there is hardly any difference between the viewport and the Anil rendered output. Obviously, when we have the scene to be finally rendered, we will render. But then if we wanted to do some lighting changes, design changes and all, we hit the render button, obviously it will take a couple of seconds. And if you want to avoid that, you can take the decisions on the viewport itself. And when you're happy with the render time, you can do the final renders using the Anil render engine. And the whole time which the Anil takes, even on the viewport versus the final render, is just hardly few seconds. Of course, it also depends on your data set. So Revit to Anil workflow is also very easy and seamless. I just don't want to talk about it, but I'm just going to play this video. You can seamlessly import Revit files. It's absolutely easy. You can just add or remove the lights which comes from Revit. And once the Revit file is inside 3ds Max, you can get rid of all these Revit lights and apply Arnold light. So Arnold is, as I said, comes free with 3ds Max. And all you need to do is convert the scene from the traditional lighting to Arnold, and all the lights which you already have can be converted to Arnold. It also supports the photometric lights and the sun positioner, which comes from 3ds Max, from the Revit or something like that. And without doing anything else, if you just hit the render button, you can see the rendered output, which is obviously not finalized, but it's still much more better than what we see it in Revit. So if you want to achieve some photorealism or photorealistic light imageries from which is not available, not possible within Revit, you can do the same using 3ds Max, and that's absolutely possible. The last one in our solution is photogrammetry recap tool. Now, what is photogrammetry recap tool? Is we have is a tool which uses an algorithm where we can click multiple pictures. We can pull data from the LiDAR scanner. So if you have a drone and the drone captures an area with multiple images and pictures or a video, the algorithm converts those images into point cloud data, and that data can be imported into recap. So you can see the thousands of pictures, you import that data and convert those data into 3D models. Now imagine these kind of models to create would take days or months, but recap makes it much more easier. So if ever you want to convert an existing building or an existing monument or a historical monument into a 3D model, instead of creating something from the scratch, you can either use multiple pictures or photographs from your mobile phone or from your DSLRs or from a drone and convert those images into a 3D model, bring it inside recap. If you have some flaws, you can just join them, stitch them, and use only those areas which is needed, and rest everything can be deleted. You can change the facets from triangles to squares, or you can do that in 3ds Max also, because we have a very good retopo tool. And here's your 3D data which you've acquired from just a photographs or point cloud data from LiDAR scanners and so on. So this is extremely easy, but you can take it in Civil 3D and do much more beyond what you would like to do. So that was a very quick presentation from my side. With the given time, I just wanted to show you what Autodesk solution in the media entertainment space is capable of doing in the design visualization space. We have 3ds Max, Arnold, which produces photorealistic imageries, and we have the Recap Pro tool, which allows you to convert your pictures, photographs into 3D models, or maybe point cloud data into 3D models. And then we have the entire stage to play around. So that was my presentation. Thanks you so much for being patient.
As Samit, Anil here again now. It's always a pleasure to interact with you. We've got some questions coming from the audience.
Sure.
As Niyati Kothari was asking in the question answer session that, can Anil be installed for 3ds Max version for free, any version before 2018?
Niyati, yes. Although we introduced Anil in the version 2018 or 19, but we did make sure that Anil supports a couple of previous versions also. So if you have 3ds Max purchased and you can go into the Autodesk account and download the 2018 version of 3ds Max, you can go to the Arnold portal and download the Arnold setup for 3ds Max 2018 and start using it.
Okay, but what if she doesn't want to go through the process of downloading the 3ds 2018? She's already downloaded and she's using it.
Yeah, if she hasn't downloaded, she'll have to download. But if she's already having 2018 3ds Max on her system, all she needs to go to the Arnold portal, arnold.autodesk.com, and she can go to the download page and download the Arnold plugin for 3ds Max 2018 Windows or.
It won't ask her to buy the latest version of 3ds Max, right?
No.
Definite.
They're very kind in that way.
Okay, great. Now, so there is another question which is coming. What are the specifications required in a system to support these software as it shows live output almost, instantaneously while being rendered?
Cool. So, there is a minimum requirement, hardware requirement for 3ds Max, Maya, all these softwares. Even if you go to the Autodesk.com and just Google it, minimum hardware requirement for 3ds Max 2022, it'll give you the caps. And it's not it's a super computer. It's a normal general computer. Now, what we wanted to do is we didn't want you to get the benefit only by changing your hardware. We wanted to make the softwares powerful so that you can get this benefit with your existing hardwares as well. So this would not require any separate hardware if you want to see this thing in viewport. Of course, it should be supported with the normal 3ds Max 2022. Then it's absolutely fine to experience the viewport, what we have shown.
Okay, there's another question which has come. Does Autodesk have warehouse like SketchUp?
We do not have, but we are now trying to, because the whole idea was because we had a lot of talents and artist community who were putting up free files on the web where people can download and so on. So we are now, it's just a thought that we're planning to have libraries of shaders and models and so on, but yeah, again, that's not what I'm going to, openly tell, but this could come up in any of the upcoming versions.
Okay, there's another question which has come up, which is talking about, if I'm an architect, I'm not really trained in 3ds Studio Max. I'm a designer, but I don't want to go. I don't want to work with a junior person who's a specialist in using it. When is it going to be so simple for me as a senior architect to be able to use it? Without having to go to a junior, it's like you have these mobile softwares where you can actually, you just have to drag and it automatically does everything. When is it going to get that simple?
True. So, I can't comment on that when is it going to be that simple, but yes, we have come a long way. We've tried to make it simpler, and more simpler. If somebody is following 3ds Max for quite some time now, at least for the last 3-4 years, we have cut down on steps. Like, any modeling which would take 8 to 10 steps can now be done in 3 or 4 steps. Similarly, automation, you don't need to render it out. You can just see it on the viewport and just take a call. which will save a lot of time as well. So certain things have been made so easier that you don't need to be an artist, whereas even if you know some design basic or maybe some other softwares, I think you can do good with 3ds Max as well.
Anyway, so Niyati is laughing a bit and saying, ha, 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 ha. Thank you for the joke about not forcing me to download the latest version, but it's been a pleasure chatting with you. Like always, Samit, look forward to our next engagement together. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I hope the architecture industry responds to your clarion call to look at your product even closer and use it for the kind of solutions you're offering. All the best to you.
Thank you so much, Sunil. Thank you, Pat.
Thank you. That was an incredible session, Samit.